welcome back to my channel Pretty 5 by Surbhi. If you are coming for the first time on my channel, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell button next to it so that you just keep getting all the updates from my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to do a quick tutorial on basic eyeshadow makeup for everyday. It's going to be a little more natural, warm, smoky makeup. So the products that you will need are few eyeshadow brushes, one fluffy and one flat brush. If you don't have any brush, it's absolutely fine, you can use your finger. The next is you need a Kohl pencil, Kohl kajal, mascara, you need a lash curler, so you need a primer, compact, and the most important, eyeshadow palette. I'm using Revolution eyeshadow palette. You can use any, but it should have some warm colors. When I say warm colors, some neutral, brownie, slight rusty colors, so that you can just create a very natural look. So I'll be starting by priming up my eyelids. I'll be using LA Girl Pro Primer HD eyeshadow primer. If you remember, in my Nykaa haul, I bought this one and I am really liking it. So I'll apply primer over my lids. I'll also apply it under the eye. So you can use any primer or concealer, you necessarily don't need to use this one. So you can use brush to blend it, or you can use fingers. I'll prefer fingers. So I'll just blend it all over my eyes. It's very creamy, smooth, blends very well. It's very important to blend eyeshadows at the inner corners of your nose, because this is the area where you get maximum shadow and darkness. Blend it under the eye too. Blend very well. No matter whether you are an oily skin or a dry skin, you must apply primer so that you don't get wrinkles and you don't get crease, and your eyeshadow stays for a longer period and it blends well. Once I'm done with the primer, I'll be using a little compact to give it a matte effect so that the eyeshadow blends very well. I'm using L'Oreal matte compact. You can use any compact or maybe a very matte, almost skin color looking eyeshadow. The whole idea of using this is to ensure that there is no creaminess on the eyelid so that it doesn't crease later. The biggest problem with eyeshadows is that they tend to crease and they create that patch, which is not very good. With the compact, I'll be using ProArt AE24 number fluffy eyeshadow brush. I'll be using a base color all over my eyelids. Fingers or any other brush that is available with you. Transition, normally use matte colors. I'll be using this color for transition. This is a little brownie color, so you can use any light brownie color. Start from the corner. Place the product here and then blend it inwards. You need to apply it slightly above the crease line. So this is the crease line where you have this bend. So this is the crease line. You need to apply transition color slightly above the crease line. If you are looking at a slightly lighter natural look, then don't apply too much of product. If you are looking at a little more warmer and a little more heavier looking eyeshadows, then you can just build it up. Once the transition color is done, I'll be using slightly darker shade. It's a little more rustish color for the crease. I'll be going slightly above the crease because I have got small hooded eyes. But if you have got regular medium sized eyes or large eyes, then you just need to stay within the crease. In my case, I'll be going slightly above the crease. Try not to hold brush in front, because then you don't get some natural strokes. So if you want a better blending, then you need to hold the brush from the end. I'll apply it at the corner and blend it inwards. Ensure both the sides looks balanced. So right now I think this eye looks heavier on this. So once I'm done with left eye, I'll start working on the right eye again and blend it. To give a slightly heavier tone, I'll be using a darker tone over the edges, just to give a little smoky effect. You need to be very, very careful with the dark colors, because if they can just create the look or they can just spoil the look completely. Corner, I'll be using a lighter color. I'll be just placing it in the inner corners. Blend it well with the outer lid color. Blend all over to give it a natural look. So the transitions are smooth. So once this is done, I'll be using plum coal pencil for tight lining. Tight lining basically means you apply kajal or coal to the upper lid, to the inner side of the upper lid, like we apply kajal in the waterline. So it helps in defining the shape of the eye if you want to skip liner. So if you want to apply liner, you can definitely apply liner, else you can just do tight lining. So now I'll be applying the same in my waterline and in the bottom lid. A very natural smoky effect, I'll be applying a little bit of coal outside the eyes and I'll be blending it, smudging it out. Using the same kajal, there's a smudger in this. I'll be blending it so that there are no sharp edges. Matching with my upper eyeshadow, I'll be using this color and applying it under the eye. Look, I'll not go too heavy, so you just need to blend it very well. Once this is done, I'll be using a lighter color to highlight under the eyebrow. For a natural look, you don't want to highlight it too much, just a little lift under the eyebrow, especially at the high point. Once this is done, we'll curl our eyelashes. Curling lashes is definitely an optional step. If you do not have an eyelash color, it's absolutely fine. You can just directly go on to applying mascara, or if you have falsies, you can start applying false lashes. The next step is mascara. I'll be using my favorite Maybelline Lash Sensation mascara. For a natural look, one coat is enough. But if you want to give a more voluminous and more heavier look, then you can go in for next coat. So now applying to the bottom lashes. Very light bottom lashes. So if you have heavier lower lashes, it will definitely look better. I hope you like the video. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up before you leave. And do subscribe to my channel. Keep smiling, keep shining, stay pretty, take care.